Good morning, everyone. Happy Monday to you. Hope you have a great week. Here's a great start to the week, hanging out with Harvey Webster. You can't beat that. Who needs a cup of coffee when you have Harvey? Okay.
Right. Back at you. A little blast of energy from Kenny in the morning.
Right.
Hey, welcome to the Museum of Natural History.
Thank you so much. All right, Harvey, you know, the elephant in the room. What are these things?
Oh, man, these things are called tardigrades or water bears. And okay. You just want to give them a hug. Unfortunately, they look a little creepy when they're big above you here, but actually they're less than a half a millimeter long. And it's part of our amazing species exhibit here at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History, which explores life at the limits. So let's talk a little bit about this guy. Check him out over here.
He's pretty creepy.
Yeah,
I got to tell you, Harv.
So this is a, you know, a model of a water bear that's really blown up. But you've got an image down here that sort of shows it on its habitat, a little tiny piece of moss. These guys have to live where there's water, and they like to eat or drink or suck sap. So they like to dig, you know, basically they eat plants.
Okay.
And if you take a look at the front of that muzzle, wouldn't you just like to pucker up there?
Not so much.
That leads to its triradiate muscular sucking pharynx.
Wow.
Try that one out.
That's a mouthful, huh?
Yeah. So these are really cool little guys, but what makes them the sort of poster child of this exhibit is what they can do. They can survive almost anything. Now, if they sense that they've lost water, they can collapse into kind of a barrel-like thing.
Like
they call
this.
It a tun.
Okay.
And in that collapse, you actually can see some of the claws here. And in that state, they can withstand temperatures as high as almost the boiling point. They can withstand temperatures down to 200 degrees below zero. They can withstand outer space. They can be in a vacuum. They can be in the pressures of the bottom of the sea.
And nothing will penetrate.
And nothing happens to them. Right. They call it cryptobiosis, or hidden life.
Okay.
And in that state, they can live kind of in suspended animation.
Wow.
And then what you do is you could maybe months later or even years later just add water and they pump right back up again.
Look at that.
They're invertebrates. They've got the eight pairs of claws there. And this is this is a cool critter. They're all over the place. There's about 1,100 species. We find
Thank
them.
Thank God they're microscopic because that thing would freak me out.
Yeah, because, but they do live here and it's something that, you know, citizen scientists, if you find them, you can find them on things like moss and under a microscope, you can see that really adorable
face.
Half of a millimeter.
Thank goodness, because that's something out of Star Wars, let me tell you. Okay, when we come back, Harvey gets naked. Naked mole rats. Just kidding.
Harvey.
Like, I wasn't in the description. That was not in the description, Kenny. Naked mole rats. So that's what we're going to show you.
Good morning. Yeah.
All right. Harvey wasn't ready for that live
show.
Yeah, he wasn't ready for that one. He's like, what? What'd you say, Kenny? No.
Thanks, Kenny.
Harvey's great, too.
Yeah, he's good.
Yeah, he's very good. That was awesome. Thanks, Kenny.